sahlan fi jamiati muslimina Indonesia. Welcome Universitas Muslim Indonesia, UMI Makassar. UMI PTS pertama di luar Pulau Jawa meraih akreditasi unggul dengan nilai A dari Badan Akreditasi Nasional Perguruan Tinggi dan masuk dalam kategori 100 besar perguruan tinggi Islam terbaik di dunia versi Unirank dan satu-satunya di luar Pulau Jawa. Pencapaian ini menjadi bukti bahwa UMI adalah perguruan tinggi bereputasi yang diakui secara nasional maupun internasional. UMI didirikan pada tanggal 23 Juni 1954 atas prakarsa para tokoh ulama, para raja, dan pemerintah. Kiprah Universitas Muslim Indonesia sebagai universitas muslim swasta terbesar di kawasan Indonesia Timur dan PTS terbaik se-Sulawesi wilayah LL Dikti 9 dengan ciri keislaman dan keindonesiaan senantiasa mengedepankan aspek keilmuan dan profesionalisme dalam melahirkan sumber daya ulul albab. UMI sebagai lembaga pendidikan dan dakwah telah mengukir deretan karya dan prestasi untuk mencerdaskan anak bangsa sebagai SDM yang mampu berdaya saing di era global, memiliki karakter moral dan karakter kinerja dengan 4 kompetensi, berpikir kritis, kreatif, komunikatif, dan kerjasama sesuai dengan visi, melahirkan manusia berilmu amaliyah, beramal ilmiah, dan berakhlakul karimah serta berdaya saing tinggi. UMI terus berinovasi dalam meningkatkan kualitas mutu dan terus bertransformasi menjadi kampus bereputasi dalam level nasional maupun internasional. Pencapaian demi pencapaian signifikan yang telah diperoleh bahkan dari 4.674 perguruan tinggi negeri dan swasta se-Indonesia, UMI berada pada peringkat 64 berdasarkan Kemenristekdikti tahun 2020. UMI juga menempati peringkat 79 perguruan tinggi berbasis layanan website dan PTS ranking teratas di Indonesia Timur. Dalam bidang sains, UMI tidak kalah canggih dengan universitas ternama besar lainnya. Torehan prestasi inilah yang kemudian mengantarkan UMI menempati ranking ke-69 dari seluruh perguruan tinggi di Indonesia berdasarkan Science and Technology Index atau SINTA. UMI saat ini membina 13 fakultas dan program pascasarjana dengan 57 program studi, 22 program studi telah terakreditasi A dan menyiapkan akreditasi internasional dengan kurikulum berbasis outcomes based education atau 46 tenaga pendidik dan 617 tenaga kependidikan. UMI memiliki guru besar sebanyak 51 orang. PTS penyumbang guru besar terbanyak untuk perguruan tinggi swasta dalam lingkup LL Dikti Wilayah 9 Sulawesi. UMI membina mahasiswa 2.166 yang berasal dari seluruh pelosok daerah di Indonesia dan di luar negeri. Mahasiswa UMI mencatat sederet prestasi baik lokal, nasional maupun internasional. UMI juga memiliki berbagai wadah kemahasiswaan yang dapat dimanfaatkan untuk pengembangan dan penalaran jiwa kreativitas, minat bakat, dan entrepreneurship. Alumni UMI saat ini mencapai 108.660 orang. Mereka telah berkarya di beragam sektor dalam maupun di luar negeri. Dalam proses mengajar di UMI, ditunjang dengan sarana dan prasarana. UMI memiliki gedung perkuliahan yang cukup representatif untuk memenuhi berbagai kebutuhan akademik dan layanan administrasi bagi seluruh unit dan dilengkapi berbagai fasilitas pembelajaran seperti laboratorium terpadu, perpustakaan berlantai 3 dikelola secara profesional dengan program sistem informasi perpustakaan berbasis integritas set information. Mahasiswa UMI disambut dengan pesantren kilat sebagai pengganti ospek dan dilanjutkan program pendidikan karakter berbasis pesantren dengan pencerahan kolbu sebagai program unggulan UMI dalam membina karakter mahasiswa yang mengintegrasikan kuliah pencerdasan intelektual dengan kuliah pencerdasan spiritual yang dipusatkan di pesantren unggulan mahasiswa UMI Dahrul Mulisin Padalampe di Kabupaten Pangkep dengan memondohkan mahasiswa-mahasiswi baru selama 1 bulan.
Thank you. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Haus katari. Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to stand up upon the arrival of the Rector and the Senate members of Universitas Muslim Indonesia.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up.
La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. الحمد يحيي ويميت
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up. Indonesian National Anthem and Mars Umi. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The Honorable, all the distinguished keynote speakers of the 3rd IC Halal Umi. The Honorable, Chief of Advisory Board, Chief of Executive Board, Chief of Supervisor Board of Umi Foundation. The Honorable, Rector and Vice Rectors of Universitas Muslim Indonesia.
The Honorable, Director of Postgraduate Program. Deans, Heads of Institutes, the Director of Pesantren Darul Mukhlisin Universitas Muslim Indonesia Padang Lampe, Director of Foreign Language Academy, Head of Library Usman bin Affan, and all participants.
Welcome to the 3rd International Conference on Halal Policy, Culture, and Sustainability Issues held by Universitas Muslim Indonesia.
First of all, let's express our thanks to the God Almighty, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the Lord of the world, the Lord of the universe, who has given us his blessings and mercy so that we can attend this opening ceremony.
Secondly, may peace be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ladies and gentlemen, let's begin our agenda today by reciting basmalah.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Next agenda will be Quran recitation by Qori Muhammad Faraz.
Assalamualaikum Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله
for the very, very beautiful recitation. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bapak Dr. Insinyur Laifa ST MT ASEAN Eng to recite dua for all of us.
Ansa kirin hamdan yuwafi wa ni'ma wa yukafi mazida ya rabbana lakal hamd kama yanbaghi li zalalika wa azimi sultanik. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Let me lead the praying session in the way of Islam. Ya Allah, we ask for the strength to always only eat and drink that is halal and taib. Allahumma inna nas'aluka khaira hadzal yaum fathahu wa nasrahu wa nurahu wa barakatahu wa hudahu wa na'udzubika min syarri hadzal yaum wasari ma fi wasari ma kablahu wasari ma badahu. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azaban nar. Walillahi rasulillahi al-fatiha. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali sayyidina. Thank you.
warahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. I'm Hannah binti Amara San. I'm a senior lecturer at School of Economic and Business, UC Putra, Malaysia. I am an accredited mediator. My interest is on mediation. My area of interest, to name a few, are dispute resolution, mediation, halal industry, Islamic banking and education, and I was a practicing lawyer before. I'm so glad that I joined the second international conference on halal issue, policy and sustainability, IC Halal Umi 2020. It was so wonderful, insightful and well presented. I have gained so much insight. I learned a lot. And I also enjoy sharing my understanding of mediation with others. I would like to praise the committee and the conference convener to hold a perfect online conference for me with all supports to the presenter from various places. I hope the third international conference on halal issue, policy and sustainability, IC Halal Umi, will bring us to another dimension with new knowledge in practical and theories. I believe the next professional ulama, then ulama professional. Thank you. Wabillahi taufiq wa hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. See you in the third halal IC Halal.
Welcoming remarks from the chairman of the third International Conference on Halal Policy, Culture and Sustainability, Universitas Muslim Indonesia. We kindly invite Bapak Dr. Muhammad Ishaq Samad, MA.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin. Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. The Honorable Chairman of Wakaf Umi Foundation and all chief department in Wakaf Umi Foundation. The Honorable Rector of UMI and Vice Rector 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Alhamdulillah, it is complete today. The Honorable Dean Faculties, Chief of the Institution, all units, all directors, including Director Hospital of Ibn Sina, and Chief Library Usman bin Affan. The Honorable all the keynote speakers, presenters and all participants that I cannot mention one by one. On this occasion, on behalf of the organizing committee, let me deliver a brief report of the third International Conference on Halal Policy, Culture and Sustainability Issues, UMI 2021. The background of this conference speakers from various countries, including speakers from UMI's own resources. Last year was successfully attended by hundreds of presenters and keynote speakers from various countries, including resources persons from UMI itself. For this reason, it is very important that this tradition be continued by holding this international conference every year, because it has been contributed to the reputation of UMI nationally and internationally recognized. So the aim of this conference to succeed of UMI, the internationalization program, at the same time to increase the trust of UMI stakeholders, especially the wider community, by entrusting UMI as a place to educate students. Ladies and gentlemen, in this conference, there will be 8 keynote speakers from 7 countries, namely Al-Mukarram Professor Dr. Haji Mansur Hamdi, and professors at the parallel session from a number of universities from Indonesia and abroad, about 64 papers which will be presented for 2 days, today and tomorrow. The presenters come from Universitas Muslim Indonesia, University Putra Malaysia, ICIA University Malaysia, University of North Sumatra, STIEM Bongaya, Universitas Khairun, Medik Veteriner Banten Province, Universitas Matlaul Anwar Banten, IKIP Muhammadiyah Maumere, Universitas Hasanuddin, University Putra Malaysia, and from Brawijaya University Malang. All the papers presented will be given 1 month to submit full paper, then will be selected to submit into International Journal Index Scopus. We have collaborated with Sofropikul Umam, PhD, from School of Science and Technology, Kwansei Gakuin University, Japan, who will support and facilitate the papers presented to be published in IOP Conference Series and the International Journal of Halal System and Sustainability. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the organizing committee, we would like to say thank you very much, especially to the board of trusted Wakaf Umi Foundation and all leaders of Wakaf Umi Foundation, and special thanks to Rector Umi and Vice Rector of Umi, all the dean faculties who delegate lectures and presenters and participants, all keynote speakers and presenters from different countries and institutions, and very special thanks to all the organizing committee and steering committee, and anyone that I cannot mention one by one who has been working very hard to prepare and organize this conference. To our beloved Rector of UMI, Professor Dr. Haji Basri Moding, SMSc, please deliver welcome speech and open the third International Conference on Halal Policy, Culture, and Sustainable Issues officially. Once again, thank you very much, and please apologize if any inconvenience before, during, and the conference. The real success is not when you can organize this conference well, but after the conference. How many papers will be published in International Journal, IOP Series Scopus, and International Journal Scopus Index? Kesuksesan sesungguhnya bukanlah pada saat kita mampu menyelenggarakan conference ini dengan sukses, tetapi setelah conference ini, kira-kira berapa paper yang bisa tembus ke IOP Scopus dan masuk di jurnal internasional. Please join the conference seriously and don't forget to be happy. Wallahu waliyut taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Thank you to the chairman of the third IC Halal UMI, Bapak Dr. Muhammad Isa Samad MA. Ladies and gentlemen, next we will listen an address from Rektor Universitas Muslim Indonesia to Bapak Profesor Dr. Haji Basri Moding, SC/MSc. The stage is yours.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Alhamdulillah wa syukrillah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi aliyyil azim. Asyhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la syarikalah wa asyhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad. The Honorable Chairman of UMI Wakaf Foundation, my brothers, all Vice Rector of UMI, Dean Faculties, Chief of the Institution, Units, and all of Director. The Honorable of Invited Speakers and Participants that I cannot mention one by one. Alhamdulillah, thanks to Allah's grace that we are able to attend the opening ceremony of the TIT International Conference on Halal Issue, Policy, Culture and Sustainability via Conference Zoom. Salawat and taslim of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for his mistake we get the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On behalf of Rector Umi, I am very delighted to say thank you very much for all of you, especially for our honorable all invited speakers, keynote speakers from different countries, and all the presenters who participate in this conference. On this occasion, let me on behalf of the Rector of the Universitas Muslim Indonesia Makassar to welcome you and joining this international conference through Zoom conference. Universitas Muslim Indonesia Makassar is increasingly playing competing with campuses in Indonesia and abroad to improve the quality of education and research. This international event attended by representatives of different countries as well as the publication of the research presented or research of students and lecture, as well as discussion current development strategy issue. The goal of the conference to encourage lecturers, researchers, and students to always collaborate in development according to the guidance and needs of the community, especially on halal issue, policy, culture, and sustainability. Also, to facilitate publication of scientific papers in proceeding or journal index by Scopus, and to know the readiness of educational institutions in implementing health policies in the area of globalization, to know the interdisciplinary cooperation that can be done to implement health policies and the implementation of health policies in developed countries. This event will be annually international conference. So we invite all the speakers and participants who would like to join the conference next year, inshallah.
Amen.
We hope all of this will benefit and very useful for the global ummah, especially on sustainability of halal issue, policy and culture in many countries. We also apologize if in the implementation of this conference there are things that inconvenient before and during the conference. Let's open the conference by saya. Mari kita sama-sama membuka conference ini dengan bersama-sama membaca Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Once again, thank you very much and please enjoy the conference. Wallahu aliyut taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Mohon berkenan Bapak Rektor Universitas Muslim Indonesia untuk tetap di tempat. And we are glad to invite Bapak Profesor Dr. Insinyur Haji Muhammad Hatta Fatah MS as a keynote speaker at representative to join Pak Rektor on the stage. And we also kindly invite the chairman of the third IC Halal UMI and the chief of supervisor and the chief of executive foundation. Kami mengundang dengan hormat ketua IC Halal UMI dan Bapak Ketua Pengawas serta Bapak Sekretaris Pengurus Yayasan Wakaf UMI untuk bergabung di panggung.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are witnessing a token of appreciation presentation from the Rector of Universitas Muslim Indonesia to the keynote speaker's representative, Bapak Profesor Dr. Haji Insinyur Muhammad Hatta Fatah. Mohon kesediaan Bapak Ibu untuk tetap tinggal di atas. Selanjutnya,
dan berkenan kami undang Bapak Wakil Rektor untuk bergabung di atas panggung.
We kindly invite Vice Rectors to come on the stage. And to the foundation board, please. Pada pengurus yayasan, dengan hormat kami juga mengundang untuk bergabung di atas panggung. It will be a memorable moment for us, and we will be remembered for this moment for the next year and years after. Thank you very much. Dean, okay, to all deans, pada seluruh dekan, we also invite you to come forward, please, to take a picture. And also to the heads
berkenan,
of institutes,
kami mengundang
kepala
dengan hormat
lembaga,
para dekan dan ketua lembaga, dan direktur pesantren, kepala perpustakaan, berkenan untuk mengambil tempat di depan.
And also the director of postgraduate program, please. Thank you very much for your attention. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a photo session. And also the director of the hospital,
Kami
Ibnu
mengundang
Sina,
dengan hormat,
please.
Direktur Rumah Sakit Ibnu Sina untuk bergabung.
...11.6 hectare with 760 farmers are participants in this program. In this quarter 2020, the workspace only accommodate 10.18% of graduate university. All university must reform his education system. University needed a new approach in education system. Currently, Indonesia government has released new program. We mention Merdeka Belajar dan Kampus Merdeka. This is a new approach in university to give student independency to develop his capacity and competency in line with his talent and interest, in line with the demand of employment and industry. And we mention is link and match with industry. Our problem today, there are missing skill of graduate student from university with demand of industry. That demand for employment is not always in accommodate with the competence of university graduate. The production of South Sulawesi tiger shrimp in the last 4 years saw production reach 20,046 ton, then decrease in 2080. And so increasing then over last 3 years. In 2020, production increased to 10,595.5 ton or 2.16% increasing compared than 2019 production. Pinrang Rejection production has consistently increased over the last 4 years and copper export mostly see 34% from total science 20 and 16. Our research use so many approach disease research design by experimental and survey method. And in Pinrang, there are 8 main program to recovery shrimp farming area, cover 1,000 hectare. The first is how to rebuild of transition farm, and the second is how to monitoring activity of the farmer group in use of land and farming of shrimp culture. The last I want to exactly the last of this program will be harvest the good quality of shrimp to export of Japan. And I want to explain our research 20 and 7. There are 4 vulnerability factor of shrimp farming area in Lan Risang District, Pinrang Regency. The first vulnerability is pathogen. The second is climate change. The third is pollution. And the last is water quality. This is main factor to mass controlling to exactly to make sure our productivity still increase. And the last research in this year, I found is so many problem, so many vulnerability, because our research area this year cover in 11.6 hectares is more wider than the last research. In this year, I found there are 5 vulnerability. The first is availability of quality larvae and juvenile. How to improve the technology in farmer level. The third is how to make a good policy. And the last, how to still controlling pathogen and how to anticipate impact of climate change. This is 2 main pathogen in our area. The first is white spot syndrome virus, WSSP, and the second is Fabriosis in shrimp, mainly is Fabrio harvei. We must controlling this pathogen, how the shrimp can to high immune to protect the infection of the pathogen. And the next problem, how to anticipate climate change problem. Every year in South Sulawesi, there is climate anomaly marked by the occurrence of La Nina and La Nino. La Nina and El Nino occurrence every year in South Sulawesi. In our research in 2009, we found in same years there are 2 phenomena. They are La Nina and El Nino. This is a situation made how many shrimp pond is fail in production of shrimp. But this is problem is make me many lesson learn how to make our production still increase every years. And the last related to the halal issue, we found our tiger shrimp export to Japan item shouldn't be one. We must improve our quality of tiger shrimp production, because in many cases I found piece of treat, grace and human hair in our production will to export to Japan. This is not accordance with the Philippines of the regulation related traceability and food safety as regulation of export in Japan and other country. To anticipate our problem in this area, I want to say to audience, we must improve our technology. The modern technology must to anticipate it, how to make sound management in our area. The farming paradigm continues to develop in line with environmental problem and challenges of increasing productivity. This is our problem. How to still encourage the farmer to increasing productivity related to problem by environment, and currently a recommended export to develop of sound management to ensure successful of black tiger shrimp farming. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our program to support Merdeka Belajar dan Kampus Merdeka. To supporting the successful of Merdeka Belajar and Kampus Merdeka, we needed ecosystem for implementation of Merdeka Belajar and Kampus Merdeka, including teaching factory. With teaching factory, we will training student to become entrepreneur or startup incubation, then and the student join the exhibition and business matching. The sign our teaching factory in Pinrang, there are four program, there are eight program. The first is how to develop Pronima stock installation. The second is transition pond operating must use standard. The third is how to develop industrial probabilizer. And four is engineering, how to make new design of pond to adaptation of the problem of climate change and environmental problem. The seven is development quality portability automatic response system or ALIRI. The last, how to still develop of community development and empowering. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our roadmap and program design in develop of our teaching factory to achievement of key performance index of Universitas Muslim Indonesia. We hope this year there are achievement of key performance index of Universitas Muslim Indonesia with producing more than publications, more than patent, and more than a student join to the entrepreneur, or more than student become an entrepreneur. This is element factor how to make key performance index of Muslim Indonesia this year more than the last year. Ladies and gentlemen, implementation of sound management in Pandawa Seribu, we make seven aquaculture management area, or we make seven block area. The seven block area designed by suitable of environment to support increasing production of shrimp. But this program problem with the sedimentation of area. Almost west coast of South Sulawesi, every year there are sedimentation. Sedimentation make all the channel of the irrigation of pond is not be open because there are so many sedimentation in irrigation of pond. And the other problem, this is main problem in our area. In Pinrang, there are the biggest seaweed processing industry, but this industry is produce pollutant. The pollutant from this industry release pollutant, liquid pollutant from Belawa River. Then Belawa River is main source of fresh water to use of the pond. This is will be make a conflict between industry and community. We suggest solution with this conflict. We will move the source of water from Belawa River to Anak Banuang River. But the problem Anak Banuang River is so narrow and so many sedimentations. But this year, supporting by Pindrang Regency, rehabilitation and normally irrigation pond in all the area of Lanrisang District, also in Anak Banuang River. We hope the next time the farmer not dependent with the Belawa Rivers and move to the Anak Banuang Rivers. It is resolution conflict with the farmer, with the industry. The industry is an investment from China. There are so many very important people in this country have investment in the industry. This is win-win solution. The farmer can increasing the production and the industry still production of seaweed. The seaweed in Pinrang, the seaweed industry in Pinrang needed 1 ton material every day, but now is only he can get 40% his material. The next time we have the industry still grow up and the pond of the farmer is still production upstream, because production from Pinrang is the best in the country. The stream from Pinrang is organic stream. It is the best in the Indonesia. Fertilizer industry. Fertilizer industry is industry from the village to encourage productivity of stream with simulated grow up of Pronima. Fertilizer to simulated of grow up Pronima, and Pronima is good natural feed prop stream, and we hope population of Pronima in our pond is still stable, and we hope sometimes productivity our pond is increased time to time. All of student this program will sign them to new entrepreneur. We sign them to become a startup. The new entrepreneur we empowering with incubation system. In the last, all the students join to exhibition and business matching. We hope all students in UMI can be a partner, entrepreneur. All students in UMI next time will be success entrepreneur. This is the other program to our teaching factory in Pinrang. We develop a sekolah lapang, field school of farmer. This is non-formal school. Then this is very important to support the increasing of productivity stream in Pinrang, and how educated the farmer to become a modern farming. This is impact on outcomes of the field school. We can increasing the productivity time to time from the stream pond, and the farmer is can get increasing income time to time after join to the field school. And the other, we join the community And we mention the community is Komunitas Pemerhati Udang Indonesia, and we mention is continue. This is a good partner join this program, and we hope we can integrate it all stakeholders from the farmer, from the hatchery, and from the entrepreneur, especially is processing product. We join this program, and we want to integrate them how to increasing our productivity and how to increasing income of the farmer, how to increasing the growth economic of district and province. This is a training from women economic empowerment, because the moment is role important in this program. Women economic empowerment post is wife of the farmer, how to increasing the economic of family, and how to support his husband to productivity in his pond. And alhamdulillah, this in the Wednesday, October 9, 2021, this is the first harvest in the Pandawa Seribu by Pak Ismail. He harvest only in 33 days, and the other case we can harvest stream in 3 months, but our program we can harvest stream only 43 days, and we harvest is size 19. We have this program is continue, and ladies and gentlemen, conclusion and our presentation today, the first is development of the Pandawa Seribu area support the revival of the tiger shrimp industry in South Sulawesi and achievement of Indonesia shrimp production target of 215%. The permeability factor in area of 1,011.6 hectare in Pandawa Seribu is more complex than result permeability research in 2017, which more only cover in area 10 hectare. This year, cover area our research is 1,000 hectare. The complexity, the area will be a good basis for development student education and competence though development of the teaching factory. Teaching factory development is relevant to effort increase income and provide employment, economic recovery effect of COVID-19, as well as link and match with higher education graduate with industry and employment. Discovery of inappropriate object of in tiger shrimp product export to Japan show the importance of education all parties of the fulfillment of traceability and food safety in line with principle of halalan toiban. The last but not least, I want to thank you so much for Governor of South Sulawesi, Pak Rektor and other leader in university, National Research and Innovation Board of Indonesia, Ministry of Education and Culture and Research of Indonesia, Pinrang Regency, and all audience and participant today. Thank you so much for your attention. This is our presentation today. Wallahu alaikum taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was insightful and eye-catching presentation from our first keynote speaker, Bapak Profesor Dr. Haji Muhammad Hatta Fatah MS. As for your information, his research on sustainable production of black tiger shrimp has brought him to be well-known scientist nationally and internationally. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all for the opening ceremony this morning, and we will continue
with parallel session. Akhirul kalam. Wallahu waliyut taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Attention to all participants, please stay, don't leave the room, because the administrator will lead you to your meeting room, because after this we are going to have the parallel session. Thank you very much, please don't leave and stay with us. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
I'm Hannah Binti Ambaras Khan. I'm a senior lecturer at School of Economic and Business, UC Putra, Malaysia. I am an accredited mediator. My interest is on mediation. My area of interest, to name a few, are dispute resolution, mediation, halal industry, Islamic banking and education, and I was a practicing lawyer before. I'm so glad that I joined the second international conference on halal issue, policy and sustainability, IC Halal Umi 2020. It was so wonderful, insightful and well presented. I have gained so much insight. I learned a lot. And I also enjoy sharing my understanding of mediation with others. I would like to praise the committee and the conference convener to hold a perfect online conference for me with all support to the presenter
about the code of conduct of the conference.
Kami akan membacakan tata tertib yang wajib dipahami dan ditaati selama mengikuti konferensi ini.